Hello, my name is Sabrina. I'm a first-year student in the nursing program. I'm here to talk to you guys about the Beers criteria. So the Beers criteria for potentially inappropriate medication use in older adults. This was developed by Mark Beers in 1991. It is for older adults, so 65 years of age and older. It is continued to still be used by the American Geriatric Association. It does have five criteria that is followed for that. Number one, medications that should typically be avoided in older patients. Number two, meds that should be avoided in older patients with certain conditions. Number three, meds that should be used with caution because of benefits that may offset the risk. Number four, medication interactions. And number five, change dosing based on kidney function. The Beers criteria do have goals that they are trying to reach. Some of those goals include to improve medication selection, to educate the physician and the patient, to avoid adverse effects, and to help evaluate care quality and medical use trends for older adults. Before we get too far into this, I think it's important to understand what polypharmacy is. In simple terms, polypharmacy is the use of multiple medications or excessive medications. This is more common in the older population, but you can also see this in younger patients as well. I think another term to understand is multimorbidity. This is the coexistence of two or more chronic health conditions at one time. Again, we see this more in our older patients. With having multiple chronic conditions, we do have to think about the fact that the complexity of therapeutic management increases as well. So why is this important? This is important because multimorbidity is linked to decreased qualities of life. So thinking about that patient, their decreased immobility and their decrease in functioning ability. According to several studies, this is also linked to increase in hospital stays, physiological disorders or distress, use of healthcare resources, mortality, and cost. Multimorbidity has increased over the last few years and is expected to rise significantly as a result of the growing number of older people and growing number of people living with multimorbidity. So the risk of polypharmacy in the geriatric population. So with this, I think it's very important to note that most of our patients 65 years and older have more than one health condition at this time. And they could be chronic conditions, acute conditions, but still they have more than one going on. So they're on multiple medications. Some of our geriatric patients are on 5 to 10 medications at a time. So we definitely need to understand what is going on with them and those medications. They may be seeing multiple providers at this time. A good question is, what is their internal organ function? What is their ability to metabolize the medications or the kidney's ability to excrete the medications? These patients are at more risk of falls, delirium, GI bleeds, confusion. So it's very important in the geriatric population to understand polypharmacy and what we can do best to help our patients. So as a nurse, kind of carrying on with that, how will I apply this knowledge? So number one, our top priority is always patient care, to do what's best for them. So by this, understanding the indications of the drugs, adverse effects, and the drug-to-drug interactions with these medications, it's very important to know all of the medications your patient is taking. Being able to give patient education and understanding. Sometimes with our elderly population, they might have a harder time understanding what we're telling them. So being able to describe this in a way that they can understand and take it home and apply it, that they know that they need to continue the whole course of medications, not just stopping when they feel better. So those are definitely all very important, instrumental things in making sure our patients are safe. Our goal as a nurse is to do what is best for our patient. So always, you know, checking yourself multiple times, making sure you are giving the right medication for the right purpose at the right dose is all very important. So thank you. This is just a brief little thing about the Beers criteria and the importance of understanding it. Thank you.